Hey there, home learning heroes. We're back again, this time for Big Book, Unit 9. That's right, we're already on Unit 9. So let's have a look at what our story and unit is all about. We'll look through the big book together. We'll talk about what we see, and then we'll read it. And then we'll read it again for fluency. So let's take a look at the front cover of Unit 9, Space Town. It's got a title. The title's at the top. Let's read together. Our cousins in Canada. Now, a cousin is when your mom or your dad has a brother or sister, and they get married and they have kids. And sometimes your cousins are around the same age as you. You might see them a lot, or you might not see them very often. These cousins, you can see from the title, live in Canada. Now that's a long ways away. And I can see some pictures of the cousins. They're looking at pictures, and the background's very different because they live in a different country. All right, let's take a look at the big A at the bottom for author. Cover it up. Jane Chan. That's the person who writes the words. And the big letter I, of course, at the bottom underneath is illustrator, Dick Fong, and he's the one who draws the pictures. So let's go ahead and take a look. If we flip the book over onto the back side, then you will see some words at the top. Now that's called a blurb. That's a very funny way to say a little bit about the story. It's called a blurb, right? So if we're gonna look at this blurb, we're gonna know more about the story before we read it. So let's take a closer look. There's the blurb on the back. Now we can share read this together, all right? Here we go. Rex and Mandy are writing notes to their cousins, Ben and Cherry, who live in Canada. They are going to visit them in the holidays. They nearly miss the plane because they can't find Rex, who is enjoying himself exploring the airport. All right, a couple questions about that. Who is our story about? You can see from the blurb already, we have Rex and Mandy. Rex and Mandy. And what are they going to be doing? It says right here, they're going to visit their cousins, Ben and Cherry, who live in Canada. And what is the problem? It gives us a little bit of a hint already, just in the blurb here. They nearly miss the plane. Rex isn't behaving very well. I think he's having too much fun going to the airport. All right, there's the blurb. Now we know more about what's happening. Let's take a look inside. This is the title page, so let's read our title again. Our Cousins in Canada. Cool. All right, opening up, I can see already they have a photo album, and inside are pictures of their cousins. And I think they're auntie and uncle too. Now, looking at the pictures, they're very different because they live a far away place in Canada. We're gonna read down here at the bottom and learn more about the cousins and what they're doing. Let's read together. This is my Aunt Pam. She is Mum's twin sister. This is my Uncle Charles. They live in Canada. Do you know what a twin sister is? If you are a twin, it means there are two of you. Maybe you look like each other, maybe you look a little different, but you were born on the same day at the same time. Twins. Let's go over to page 3 and we can read more about what's happening. Ready? These are my cousins, Ben and Cherry. So I can see the pictures right here. There's Ben, there's Cherry, and then this must be uncle and aunt. All right, that gives us a good start. Now, I can see that they are doing something. Looks like they're getting ready to send a package. There's a parcel. A package can be called a parcel. And inside this big box, looks like there's some presents for them. And they're writing notes. I bet you can guess, who are they writing notes? Who are they going to write to? Probably their cousins. We can read at the bottom here with me. Mom is putting birthday presents in a parcel for Aunt Pam. Over on the other side now. We are writing notes to Ben and Cherry. We are going to visit them in the holidays. Wow, so they're going to send some birthday presents. I bet that would be fun. And little notes to Ben and Cherry. That's nice. Okay, we can see clearly the notes here that they wrote. We have one note here is for Ben, and one note over here is for Cherry. You put the person you're writing to at the top, and at the bottom, we have the from Rex. So that's who wrote it, and from Mandy. Let's read what it says down at the bottom. We are putting our notes in the parcel. And we can read the notes too, if you'd like. Hi, Ben. This is me with my pet. He is big. He's friendly. Do you have a pet? From Rex. And he put a picture in there of his big friend. That's a puppy. Over here, we can read on Cherry's. Hi, Cherry. This is me with my best friend, Lisa. We like swimming. Who's your best friend? From Mandy. Did you notice that both Rex and Mandy asked a question at the end? They want to know more, and that's how you can start a conversation. That looks like fun. All right, there's a post box, and it's empty. Look at their faces. How does Rex feel? I think he's a bit disappointed. Nothing's in there. I wonder what he wants to have happen. Who is he waiting for to send him something? Let's read at the bottom. Mom is waiting for a parcel from Aunt Pam. We are waiting for notes from Ben and Cherry. So when you send somebody a note, you want to get one back. And I think Rex is waiting a long time. And there it comes. Patience is good. All right, they feel very happy. They have paper in their hands. That must be the notes. And some parcel here with presents. Let's read. Hooray! The parcel is here. The notes are here. Cool. So when you send somebody something, maybe you get something back. And then I have two letters here. The first one is, let me get to it. The first one is to Mandy, and the second one is to Rex. Let's take a look at the first one for Mandy. All right, let's read. Hi, Mandy. My best friend's name is Anne. We like ice skating. See you soon. From Cherry. So she answered the question, who's her best friend? And what does she like to do? Ice skating. In Canada, it's very cold sometimes, so you can go ice skating outside. And our next one is from Ben. Let's see what he replies. We can read, Hi, Rex. I have a pet pony. His name is Jet Black. See you soon. From Ben. He has a pony. That's like a baby horse, a small horse. It doesn't look like he can ride the horse very well, though. That sounds neat. Jet Black. Maybe the horse is black color, so we call him Jet Black. All right. It looks like now they don't have parcels. I can see they have something else that they're putting things into. This is a suitcase. And what do you use a suitcase for? To go on holiday. I think it's time for them to go visit their cousins. So they're packing their clothes, and looks like Rex has something that he wants to bring for Jet Black. That's the horse. What does that word say? Carrots. He's going to bring carrots to feed the horse. That's kind. Let's do it together at the bottom. The holidays are here. We are very excited. I'd be excited too. All right. I can see Mom and Dad are in the bed. The time, look at the clock. The time is 3. I think it's 3 a.m., 3 in the morning. Look at Rex and Mandy. They are so excited. They're jumping on the bed. It's time to go. It's time to go. Can we go yet? Oh, Mom and Dad are still asleep. All right. They're very excited. They're up early. Let's read. Today, we are going to Canada. They are so happy. Now, you can see the picture. Where are they? There's a plane in the background, so they must be at the airport. And there is Mandy looking confused. Mom and Dad, I think they're trying to find where their plane is. And look at, there goes Rex. He's going the wrong way. We can read. We can see many people at the airport. Where is Rex? I think Rex is going off by himself. Oh, there he is again. He's not staying with the family. Is that a good thing or a bad thing for Rex? When you go to the airport, should you stay with your mom and dad? I think so. Here we go. We are waiting for the plane. Where is Rex? Yeah, it can be a long time to wait for your plane, but you need to stay close. Uh-oh, it's time for them to check in. He's got the tickets, but what's missing? Something's missing. Let's read. Our plane is ready to leave. Where is Rex? All right, let's make a prediction. What do you think will happen next? You can use the words, I think. Now the plane's gonna go. Are they going to get on the plane? Will they miss the plane? I don't know. Say, I think, and tell me what will happen next. Let's find out. There he is. It looks like this man here, he must work at the airport. He found Rex and he's wheeling him. Oh, look at Mom and Dad and Mandy are all relieved. Whew, we finally found him. At the bottom, here is Rex. Now, Rex is a bit naughty. All right, and that's the end of our story. Look at all these content words and high frequency words. Now I want you to go through them, but we won't do it together. You can pause the video and I want you to read each list. Make sure that you know these words and you can say these words so then when we read it again, you'll be very good. So pause the video now, read all your words, and then we'll go back and read it for fluency. I would like to take a trip to Canada. That sounds like fun. All right, we'll start at the front cover. I'm gonna read it. You can read along with me. You can turn off the sound or you just try yourself. Here we go. Our cousins in Canada. Rex and Mandy are writing notes to their cousins, Ben and Sherry, who live in Canada. They are going to visit them in the holidays. They nearly miss the plane because they can't find Rex, who is enjoying himself exploring the airport. This is my Aunt Pam. She is Mum's twin sister. This is my Uncle Charles. They live in Canada. These are my cousins, Ben and Cherry. Mom is putting birthday presents in a parcel for Aunt Pam. We are writing notes to Ben and Cherry. We are going to visit them in the holidays. We are putting our notes in the parcel. Hi, Ben. This is me with my pet. He is big. He's friendly. Do you have a pet? From Rex. Hi, Cherry. This is me with my best friend, Lisa. We like swimming. Who's your best friend? From Mandy. Mom is waiting for a parcel from Aunt Pam. We are waiting for notes from Ben and Cherry. Hooray! The parcel is here. The notes are here. To Mandy, to Rex. Hi, Mandy. My best friend's name is Anne. We like ice skating. See you soon, from Cherry. Hi Rex, I have a pet pony. His name is Jet Black. See you soon, from Ben. The holidays are here. We are very excited. Today, we are going to Canada. We can see many people at the airport. Where is Rex? We are waiting for the plane. Where is Rex? Our plane is ready to leave. Where is Rex? Here is Rex. The end. All right, well done. Hey, let's take a quick look at the orientation. That's the who, the when, and the where. These are pretty easy questions. You know, the blurb on the back also helps us with the orientation. So who's in the story? Well, we have all the characters. We have Mom and Dad, we have Aunt and Uncle, and we have the kids, Mandy, and we have the cousins as well. Mandy and Rex, and then the cousins are Ben and Cherry. When does it happen? Well, probably sometime during the summer holidays, because they don't have to go to school. Where does it happen? At their home, and they're excited to get on an airplane, so also at the airport. All right, events. What things happen in our story? What events happen? They send a parcel to their cousins and notes, and then they get a parcel back with notes. They pack their suitcases. They head to the airport to go visit their cousins. But what is the problem? Remember, every story has a problem. Well, they kind of lose somebody at the airport, right? Where is Rex? They might miss their plane. They might not get to go see their cousins. But in the end, the big word is resolution. How does it end? Well, they finally find Rex, and I think they get on the plane to go visit their cousins. Hey, that's it. Well done. That's Unit 9, Our Cousins in Canada. Now, come back and see me, and we will do the home reading books together. All right, until then, I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.